Summer solstice has passed, our last frost date has come and gone, and we've been enjoying a beautiful spring harvest. Tons of spinach, little radishes, sweet crispy little peas. But now things are starting to warm up, and likely it is time to start pulling those spring crops and get ready for a second or maybe a third succession. So let's talk about some tips for refreshing your garden. First things first, so important. When you're clearing out your space, be sure to pull everything out, any diseased plants, anything old and bolted, to make room for what we're going to sow next. You're going to lightly scratch the surface of the soil and add a fresh layer of compost just to rejuvenate and get some nutrients back in the soil. Next, and so important, you really want to keep in mind your local climate. You may have a blistering hot summer ahead, or you may live somewhere where you're going to be expecting lots of rain or really mild weather. This is going to impact the choices that you make and the varieties that you plant. Fortunately, you can learn everything you need to know about your local climate through your local university extension program or your Master Gardeners program. For just about every university in the country, there is a month-by-month planting guide for your state. You also can consult with your Master Gardeners program to find out what works this time of year if you have questions. This is especially important if you live in kind of an extreme climate, where you're very far north and you're expecting your first frost soon, or if you're very far south and you're going to be looking at some really extreme summer weather. For most of us with fairly mild summers, the opportunities are fairly open as to what you can plant, and this list should work great for you. So with each crop that you intend to plant, you're going to determine whether it is cold sensitive or cold hardy. This is just important because you're going to be budgeting. How many frost-free days do you have left in your season, and do I have time to get this crop to maturity before that first frost hits? This is super important if you're planting something kind of long season and cold sensitive, like pumpkins. It's really important to figure out your specific region's average last frost date. This information is easily found online. You can use your zip code or your county to figure it out. But what you're going to do is mark that average last frost date on the calendar, because you're going to be counting back to determine how much time you have before that frost. Okay, with all of those tips in mind, here is my list of the top 10 crops to plant for a summer refresh. Bitter melon is an awesome choice this time of year. Maybe you've pulled out your peas and you've got a trellis empty and ready to roll. Get your bitter melon growing up that trellis. It loves the heat of summer, and they are incredibly heat tolerant and easy to grow midsummer crop. I love the Chinese multicolor spinach because it maintains this really incredible gourmet quality, all the while being super heat tolerant, much more heat tolerant than many other greens, and it's got this really fantastic flavor. It's quick to germinate and easy to grow. If you're looking to add a little ornamental value to the garden, the split second morning glory is an awesome choice. This is going to thrive in hot weather. It's super easy to grow. It really loves to grow up a trellis, a fence, or anywhere that it can be allowed to climb. And I love it because it's really unique. I've never seen a morning glory with this kind of form. It's split and fluffy, totally different, almost unrecognizable as a morning glory. And it's got these sweet heart-shaped leaves. So if you're looking for a little departure from the norm, try Alabama red okra. It's a little bit more ornamental, it's got excellent flavor, and it's highly prolific. The time is now to plant some beans. I love the red swan bush bean because I've never seen a green bean this beautiful color crimson. So it's going to add this really nice ornamental pop of color to your garden. And they're also really tasty and prolific. If you are expecting a super hot summer, you might want to try a long bean. This is actually a type of cowpea, but it makes these incredibly long, super tender and tasty green beans. So I suggest the Chinese red noodle bean. It's beautiful, ornamental, adds this really beautiful pop of color. It does grow up a trellis or an arbor. It's a climbing bean, and it's really, really tasty. Now is an excellent time to plant your squash. The peak of squash bug season has passed by about mid to late June, and your plants should fare much better now. The Yuji Jingbing Gua squash can be harvested as a summer squash when it's tender and buttery, or you can allow it to stay on the plant and mature to a really nice sweet winter squash. I love this variety because it's versatile. You can choose for a winter or a summer squash. It's also great if you've got an impending frost date coming, you can harvest just as summer squash and you'll still get lots of food to eat. It's also nice right now to get a melon planted, especially if you choose a melon that matures quickly. I love the Kiku chrysanthemum melon because it's unlike any melon I've had before. It's really not a musk melon or a honeydew. It's a more crisp and tart flavored melon in the Asian melon category. It's really prolific and it's going to mature a lot earlier than some of the other melon varieties, so I highly recommend. So the weather is perfect for planting cucumbers right now. I suggest you try the Richmond Green Apple cucumber because it's a little bit of a departure from the norm. It's got a crispy flesh and it's got this sweet, tangy flavor. It's nicely balanced. It's just a little bit different and really tasty. I really love the Akoko Mesa basil. It's from Ghana. It's got a little bit of a different flavor and fragrance, but it's got everything you love about a basil. It's heat tolerant and it's this lovely, fragrant ornamental. So those are my top tips for a summer refresh. Happy gardening!